हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी विल स्टडी वन इम्पॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ इथो इंटीग्रल ऑफ अ सिंपल प्रोसेस नोन एज इथो आइसोमेट्री. सो लेट मी फर्स्ट राइट डाउन द स्टेटमेंट एंड देन विल डिस्कस द प्रूफ ऑफ इट. सो द इथो आइसोमेट्री स्टेटमेंट इज लाइक दिस. द नोटेशंस आर कंटिन्यूड फ्रॉम द लास्ट लेक्चर. सो xt इज अ सिंपल प्रोसेस, zt इज अ ब्राउनियन मोशन. Then expectation of integral 0 to t x is dz is whole square. This is same as expectation of integral 0 to t x square u du. First, let us try to understand what this means. What we are trying to compute is expectation of square of some integral, okay, and we are saying that it becomes equal to expectation of integral of square. Okay, so square is going inside the integral. And second thing, this is an Itô integral, right? This is an integral with respect to Brownian motion, whereas this is du, means this is your usual simple integral. Okay, so Itô integral is becoming usual integral and the square is going inside the integral sign. This is actually Itô isometry, so we will try to prove it. Okay, for that we'll again use the properties of conditional expectation and properties of Itô integral that we have studied. So just to recall, xs is a simple process, so this is a simple stochastic process. And zt is a standard Brownian motion. Okay, so this is as it is. Okay, now what we know is I0 would be 0. Okay, Itô integral at time 0 would be 0 because my zt starts with 0, z0 is 0. Okay, and in a martingale, we know that expectation of a martingale becomes constant. Why? Because expectation of it can be written as expectation of it given fs, where s is say less than t. And we know by property of martingale, the inside expectation becomes is. Okay, so this is for every s less than t, and hence expectation is a constant process. So for every s and t, expectation is equal. And because I0 is 0, expectation of I0 is 0, and hence expectation of it is 0 for every t. Okay, because expectation is constant and at 0 it is 0, so it has to be 0 for every t. Okay, we are going to use this property. So because expectation is 0, when I want to compute variance of it, I can write variance of it as simply expectation of I square t. Okay, and expectation of I square t is nothing but the LHS in my Itô isometry, right? Expectation of square of the integral. Okay, so that is actually same as variance of the Itô integral. Okay, so expectation of I square t would become expectation of integral 0 to t xs dzs whole square. Okay, now let us substitute value of it. For a simple process, we know that it becomes, again we'll see where t is. So suppose this is 0, this is capital T, small t somewhere here, and let us suppose it is in the interval tj to tj plus 1. Okay, then by definition IT becomes sum over I going from 0 to j minus 1 wi omega, okay, z ti plus 1 minus z ti plus wj omega zt minus ztj. Okay, we have seen this in the earlier lecture. Okay, so this I could write as sum over I going from 0 to j wi omega di, where di is the difference or increment. So di is defined as zti plus 1 minus zti for I going from 0, 1, 2 up to j minus 1. And for jth interval, we define it slightly differently. So dj becomes zt minus ztj. Okay? Okay. And now what would be I square t? I square t would be sum over I going from 0 to j wi omega di whole square, correct? And square of the sum we know is sum of squares plus sum of products. So this becomes sum over I going from 0 to j wi square omega di square, okay, plus sum over, instead of taking two times, we would just say I not equal to k, wi wk di dk. Okay, if you write I less than k, it would be two times wi wk di dk. Is it okay? I'm just expanding the whole square. If you are not convinced, maybe take j equal to 3 and try to expand and verify. Okay, so we now need to compute expectation of I square t, right? So let us try to compute expectation of wi wk di dk product term. Okay, now I not equal to k, when we write, let me assume I less than k. Okay, wi wk di dk I less than k, then we will condition over the smaller sigma field. Okay, so marginal expectation we could write as expectation of conditional expectation, and we condition over FTI. So then if we condition over FTI, if TI is here and TK is somewhere here, then WI and DI can come outside, but we are still dealing with WK into DK and we don't know anything about that process. Okay, we don't know anything about expectation of the product WK into DK. So instead of conditioning over I, if I condition over K, TK, then WK also becomes known just at that time point TK. So the only thing that remains unknown becomes DK. Okay, because DK involves ZTK plus 1, the future. Okay, so this would become expectation of WI, WK, DI, and an expectation of DK given FTK. And exactly the same argument. DK is now increment, which is independent of the past. So the marginal expectation is same as conditional expectation, and marginal expectation of increment is 0. So this is 0. Okay, so for I less than K, this is 0, and there is a symmetry. Means if I is greater than K, then we would still condition over the other thing and we would get 0. Okay, so these terms are not going to contribute. So we are left with only the square terms. Now what can we say about square terms? Expectation of wi square di square, I can write as expectation of wi square di square, and we would again condition on ti. So again here, just at that point ti, wi becomes known, so it comes outside the expectation. So wi square, expectation of di square given fti. Now expectation of di square, di is increment, right? Zti plus 1 minus zti. Expectation of square of that is same as conditional variance of that, because mean is 0, so expectation of square is same as variance, and conditional variance is same as marginal variance because of the independence of increments. So this becomes variance of di, and we know for a Brownian motion, increments, variance of the increments is same as length of the time interval. Okay, because it's a standard Brownian motion, so sigma doesn't come into picture. So we have simply ti plus 1 minus ti. Okay, so what do we have? We have expectation of wi square di as expectation of wi square into ti plus 1 minus ti. Okay, and expectation of I square t is now sum over expectation of wi square ti plus 1 minus ti, because the rest of the product terms are anyway 0 in expectation. Okay, now here ti plus 1 minus ti is anyway free from expectation, so it can be taken outside. Ti, expectation of wi square. Okay, so sum over I going from 0 to j. We know that jth, for jth term it will be different, so let me write j minus 1 plus t minus tj, expectation of wj square. Okay, and we know for a simple process xu is constant, that is xu takes value wi when u is in the interval ti to ti plus 1. Okay, so wi square into ti plus 1 minus ti can actually be written as ti to ti plus 1 integral of x square u du, because x square u is constant, that is wi square, so it comes outside, and du becomes, integral over du becomes ti plus 1 minus ti. Is it okay? Try solving from RHS to LHS. That would be easier. Okay. Similarly, wj square t minus tj could be written as integral tj to t x square u du. Okay. So combining these, I get expectation of I square t as sum over I going from 0 to j minus 1, expectation of integral x square u du ti to ti plus 1 plus expectation of tj to t x square u du. Okay. So if I add all these things, this is basically expectation of 0 to t x square u du. Okay, and this is what we wanted to prove, right? That d square can go inside the integral and
the integral with respect to Brownian motion becomes usual integral. Okay, so this is known as Itô isometry. Okay, so let me stop here. We'll study few more properties of Itô integral in the next lecture.